Soccer.net, 3 stars of the Stanley Cup deciding game. Henrik Zetterberg scores the winner, Pavel Datsyuk and Evgeny Malkin. Party continues here at Mellon Arena in Pittsburgh. They got him out of Winnipeg for a loony. It's a legendary story how they got Chris Draper, and it's the same way we got you, Scott, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. I wasn't worth a dollar. He was. All right, Chris Draper, Kennedy, Keenan, and Chris's father, Mike. This is the Draper contingent to celebrate the Stanley Cup. Let me ask you, first of all, this is your fourth Stanley Cup, one of 5 wings to win your fourth tonight. How does that sound to a player acquired on $1 waivers from Winnipeg in 1993?
Not too bad, eh? I mean, I just can't say enough about how fortunate I've been to been with this organization, to play with the great players that I played with, and it's unreal. What a great feeling, and to have my family here. Little Cameron Rose couldn't make it. She's 2 weeks old, but I got Kennedy and Keenan, like you said, and my wife's here and my dad, and it's an unbelievable feeling.
And Mike's here with a good friend of yours, Doug Kelcher. You've never seen Chris lose on the road, is that right?
Not in the Stanley Cup final. No, we haven't. And it's unbelievable because we've been to all the games over the years, and we have never lost on the road with the Red Wings.
Kennedy, what do you think of your dad tonight?
Really cool.
Keenan, what do you think?
Wings, buddy, hey?
I don't know what this is.
All right, Chris, one last question. Who are you thinking of tonight? Who do you share this with beside your teammates?
My family. You know, I just can't say enough about this. My mom's at home watching the game, my sisters, friends. It's unbelievable, and like I said, just so fortunate to play with so many great players and such a great organization, and I'm just so proud of Nick Lidstrom, the first European captain to win it. A lot of people question if we could get it done, and we got it done, and it's an unbelievable feeling.
Congratulations, Chris. Thanks for your time, and enjoy the night.
Thanks, Scott. Appreciate it.
All right, to Kelly Rudy and Craig Simpson.
Well, Craig, I think that, in my opinion, this goes back to Game 6, Dallas-Detroit, and all the momentum going in Dallas's favor, and Nick Lidstrom, as the captain, said that his job is to make sure that his players were loose, and they obviously were just that, and I think that relates to tonight's game and the influence he has on his teammates.
It really does, and, you know, we all talked about experience coming in and how important it would be with a captain like that that sets the table for everybody, that makes everybody believe that everything's going to be all right is so important. And you think of the leadership he's followed with Steve Yzerman and how much he's grown from going to not winning and being disappointed. Steve Yzerman, interestingly enough, staying up and talking with Colin Campbell up there. I find that really interesting, not going down and not wanting to intrude on the players down there.
Let's go back to the ice with Scott Oak and Dan Cleary.
Kelly, thanks very much. Yes, Dan Cleary is going to bring the Stanley Cup back to Harbor Grace. What's it going to mean to you?
It's going to mean everything. This is it. Finally, a Stanley Cup champion. Riverhead is celebrating tonight in Harbor Grace. I know the whole province is excited, and I can't wait to bring it home.
Yeah, we had a couple of shots of them during the game, and they're doing it up big in Harbor Grace tonight. In fact, we're seeing a shot right now. You can't see it because we haven't got a monitor here, but what do you think it's like back there?
It's crazy. I know it's crazy. I know the boys are going crazy. I know everybody's really happy, and, you know, they're really happy for me and my family and for the province.
All right, thank you, boys. Yes, Dallas Drake introduces to the Drake family.
Jackson, I got Darby and Delaney. I got my son Dyson at home watching the game with my mom and dad, Jim and Ann, so hi.
Dallas, you played at Northern Michigan when you signed with Detroit this year from St. Louis. In many ways, you were coming home because you started your NHL career with Detroit. So Dallas Drake comes home 15 years later to win the Stanley Cup. How does that headline sound to you?
It's unbelievable. A year ago today, I didn't know where I'd be. You know, the Red Wings gave me a chance to come play. I couldn't be more honored and thankful for the chance they gave me. And thank you very much, man. I'm just very grateful.
You know, 14 years, Winnipeg, St. Louis, Phoenix, you never really got close. Was the dream always vivid?
It was always very vivid. This year I knew we had a real good chance right from the get-go. You think about it a little bit more. It's very stressful, and it's so hard to get here, let alone win it. I'm so proud of these guys.
Who do you share this with tonight besides these guys and your teammates, Dallas?
Well, my mom and dad are back in my home in Detroit, so we're going to go back there and celebrate with them, but right now it's going to be these guys.
Thanks a lot, Dallas. Right. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Kelly, Craig.
Thanks, Scott. I think it tells you everything about Dallas Drake and Nick Lidstrom after accepting the cup from the commissioner. First player he gives it to is Dallas Drake, and the emotion that he must have felt.
Yeah, and there are so many stories like that of players who have put their heart and soul into the game and have had success as individuals, but not ever being a part of a team. And you just see it on their face. The young kids that get an opportunity to come up during the playoffs, they watch the experience. And that's really how you pass it along. The players from the minors who get a chance to be here and to see what it's like in the sacrifice that you need in the Stanley Cup, Pavel Datsyuk, again, his second Stanley Cup, but boy, what a much different Datsyuk this was. A key contributor every single night, so much depth to this organization. But Zetterberg and Datsyuk were outstanding.
Well, like Datsyuk, you were a two-time Stanley Cup winner. How is the emotion different compared to your first?
It's completely different. The first is so overwhelming. You see it in the faces there. You call home. You think about your mom and your dad. And, you know, I guess you always feel like you're going to get there another opportunity again. But the second time for me was so much sweeter. You have an opportunity to share it with your family, your wife, and your kids. And that's something that you really can't take for granted. You think of Chris Chelios, you know, the years that he's gone through in his career at 46 years old, the emotions to share it with now his grown-up family, a much different experience than winning back in 1986, his first one.
Well, Ken Holland's done a wonderful job along with Jim Nill and all the other administrators with the Red Wings. You think this is actually a team that's built for the future, even with all their stars. I think their salary cap hit right now is only $39 million, so they can actually build upon what they already have right now.
And they can, and it all starts from the top. I mean, the Ilitch family has been such great supporters. You heard Mrs. Ilitch talk about the players as family, and I think that's where the respect goes both ways. And a lot of people talk about players in Detroit playing for less money. Well, they play because of this, winning the Stanley Cup.
Well, Scott has Brad Stewart down on the ice level. Let's go to Scott.
Kelly, thanks very much. Brad Stewart from Rocky Mountain House, Alberta, was the key. In fact, I guess the only big deal that Ken Holland made at the deadline. When you were acquired from Los Angeles, did you envision this celebration?
Well, I certainly had hoped that this is what it would come to. You never know what to expect, but you know, it's been a great ride, and you know, everybody's just been has been unbelievable in making me feel, you know, from day one, like I was a part of the team.
Now, Zetterberg and Datsyuk were magnificent offensively tonight, but for much of this series, they concentrated on defense to the extent that I think after four games, you were leading the team with 6 points. Did that surprise even you?
Yeah, a little bit. Sometimes you get lucky, you know, that's all I can say about that. But, you know, when you're top two players are, you know, two of your top defensive players and they're nominated for the Selke, I mean, that says a lot about your team. And, you know, I think they're kind of, you know, they kind of just say, you know, what needs to be said about our team.
What a fortuitous time in your life, though, Brad. You come from Los Angeles. They were well out of the playoff run by Christmas time, and tonight you win the Stanley Cup. Have you thought about, you know, how lucky you've been here?
Oh, yeah, for sure. You know, I mean, kind of go from worst to first, and, you know, but I just tried to do what I could to be a part of the team, and, you know, like I said before, everybody was real good at making me feel comfortable, and you know, a real humble, awesome group of guys here, and I think that's you know, why we're at where we're at right now.
Beyond your teammates, who are you thinking of tonight?
Well, obviously my wife, who wasn't able to be here, two boys, stepdaughter Sierra, and I guess anybody in Rocky Mountain House or from Rocky Mountain House that's watching tonight.
Brad, thanks for your time. Congratulations on the Stanley Cup win.
Okay, thanks a lot.
All right, Elliot Friedman.
Well, Scott, the room is finally looking like it's about to get started here. Brian Rafalski next to me. And first of all, Brian, you had a lot of choices. You could have taken more money somewhere else in the offseason. Does this make it all worthwhile?
Yeah, I mean, to do this at home, family around, family here in the final game. And, you know, it's a dream that I've had growing up, you know, watching the Wings through the tough years, you know, through some of the good years too, the, you know, even in the 90s. You know, this is special, and it's something they can't take away from me now, and I'm always part of the Red Wings.
You could have had the Stanley Cup winning goal on two occasions in this series. Just have you've won before, but have you ever felt you played better at a bigger time than you did to close this one out?
You'd always like to play a little better, but you know, yeah, I think I've played better. You know, I was battling a little injury here, so you know, hip, so I had having trouble skating a little bit. But you know, battle through and you know, do what you have to do. And you know, the 2000 year, I thought we did a great job. You know, it's Modano and all those guys, mm-hmm. and Leighton. And but you know, these guys here, you got, you know, Crosby, Hossa, and Malkin. I mean, that's a pretty impeccable line to go up there and try to stop. So you know, I got to give those guys credit. They played a great series, and you know, we just came out on top in the end.
Just finally, before we let you go, you mentioned you're celebrating with family. I saw your kids come running in behind you here as you showed them the Stanley Cup. Just tell us who you're celebrating with.
Well, you know, my wife and kids came down, and my dad and stepmom, and you know, I'm sure we'll have a lot more family back in Detroit when we get back. So,
thanks very much, Brian. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Scott?
Cromwell, I'm going to start with a bit of a statement. Mike Babcock said to me earlier in this playoff run, I think if we had Nick Cromwell, in the playoffs last year. We don't go out in the third round. We win the Stanley Cup. How do you feel about that?
Well, of course, that makes you feel pretty good. But, you know, we live in the now, and I'm just so happy to be a part of this team.
You know, there's seven Swedes on this team. Do you think you guys have made a statement about Swedish hockey players?
I hope so. But at the same time, I don't think anybody on this team feels like we're Swedish or Europeans, whatever. All the players on this team has a role, and they're all different role players, and I think everybody fits in pretty good.
Well, and on that topic, let's go beyond Sweden, because I think half the roster is made up of European players. What's that say about the Wings?
Good scouting. I think it's a credit to the whole organization, not only to bring in good players, but also bring in great people.
Nick, who do you have here tonight? Was that your mother there?
Yeah, I got my mom, my younger brother, and my girlfriend is all here.
All right. Beyond your family and your teammates, who do you share the Stanley Cup with?
Well, hopefully all of Detroit the next couple of days. The crowd at home has been fantastic.
How are you going to remember the Stanley Cup run?
Well, hopefully, I really don't know at this time, to be honest with you. Right now, everything is a little overwhelming, and I just want to enjoy the moment.
Yeah, and you're entitled to that. Take a few days and think about it. All right, Nick, thanks for your time. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Craig and Kelly.
Thanks, Scott. Well, Craig, I think it's pretty appropriate, given the outstanding defensemen on Detroit, that we just listened to Brad Stewart, Brian Rafalski, and Nicholas Cronwall. Talk to us about the six-man unit, and if you want to include Chris Chelios, seven-man, and just the great job that they've been able to do.
I think what we've seen is the incredible depth. And, you know, you talk about Ken Holland, the little moves that he made. Rafalski was, in some sense, an easy one. He was a hometown guy. He's had experience and won cups. Stewart, though, fits that bill, and he just fits in perfectly. And you look at the last two Stanley Cup winners, the Anaheim Ducks last year and the Detroit Red Wings, you have to look to the back end. The ability to make plays under pressure, the stretch passes, the deft plays. I think we saw such a great example of Lidstrom and Rafalski.
All right. Let's go back to the ice. Michael Samuelson with Scott.
All right, Kelly, yeah, you had two big goals in the first game of this series, so I guess we conclude the Borja Salming stick's working for you, right? The G1.
Yeah, it's working.
Michael, you came here as a free agent in 05, traded three times. Why did it work here for you? Why is it working here as opposed to Pittsburgh, New York, and Florida?
Yeah, what should I say? I had a great time in Rangers, too. But, Detroit, I felt at home right away. Got off to a great start, and... a lot of Swedes there that helped me in the very beginning. The coach believed in me, so there's a lot of things. And also, I play with good players, so that helps too. So,
you and I talked about this the other day, but can we now conclude that the Stanley Cup is bigger in Sweden than either the World Championship or an Olympic gold, given the fact there are seven Swedes on this team?
Yeah, I don't know. People gotta have their thoughts of it. For me personally, I'd just say yes, probably, because it's harder to win the Stanley Cup. It's so many games, and it's so many hard games, so it's huge.
Who's on your mind tonight? Who are you thinking about as you celebrate the Stanley Cup victory?
No, I'm thinking of my family, my future wife, and my kids, for sure, and also my father and brother is here, so there's a lot of guys.
All right, thank you, Michael.
Yeah, thanks.
Thomas Holmstrom. Caused the Pittsburgh Penguins a lot of grief by stationing yourself in front of Marc-Andre Fleury. How much do you think you frustrated the Penguins in this series, Thomas?
When you go through the net hard and around the net, you're going to get tossed back and forth, and that's where everything happened. And, they got some big boys around the net and play hard, and it's a battle around the net for sure, and just try to fight for your ground.
You guys were matched up for most of the series against the Crosby line. How motivated were you and Zetterberg in that suit to outplay that line?
No, it's we knew for sure it's going to be a big test for us, and with that speed, and it's a little bit scary, especially for me who got some problem with the skating compared to those guys. So, I think Hank and Paul, they play grand, really great against them for sure, and. I think we played through the four lines really good. It's not just one line.
This is your fourth Stanley Cup. When you played in your first Stanley Cup playoffs in 1997, I don't think you played a game in the final.
No.
Probably felt a bit like an outsider that night. How much different is it tonight?
It's sick though. Yeah, it's they're all different for sure. And I never forget my first one. And for sure, you learn through the years and. I could never believe I could be back here for a fourth one.
Quickly, who are you sharing this victory with tonight besides your teammates?
For sure, my dad, he's been there all the time, and my mom and my wife, you know, they've been my side for sure, and up and downs.
Congratulations, Thomas.
Thank you so much.
Elliot.
Thanks very much, Scott. With Aaron Downey, he's holding a champagne bottle in his hand. He's going to pop it in a second when his parents come in here, but aside from your parents, who's that dedicated to?
This goes out to Shelburne and Honeywood.
Ontario.
Good folks back home, everybody rooting back home. This goes out to everybody back home here.
Yeah!
Woo! Aaron, in a lot of ways, didn't play here in the Stanley Cup playoffs, but he's so important to the mood of the team. He's getting the bath already here. There's a great story that Mike Modano tells about you, about how you hid in the room in Dallas where they had the Gatorade, and you jumped out and scared everybody, except you fell first. You know, the role you play on this team, how important is it for everybody else?
Well, you know what? They just take what you take. You know, I signed up for this role, and just go out there and just try to lead by spirit and try to lead by example. And, you know, the great thing about the role is to be part of a team, you know, accept an attitude at the end of the day and live with the attitude. We all have choices to make. We all have choices to make, whether you want to be happy or you want to be sad, and I choose to be happy every single day, and that's the attitude you bring. It's unconditional, and you bring it to the team, and it's contagious. So that was the attitude I chose to take since day one when I started out to play hockey.
Now, the people who are happiest for you are right here. Why aren't you interested?
Pop this for the two people that raised me.
Shelburne Honeywood, right here.
Just a word about Aaron and the special feelings that you guys must have to see him celebrate right now.
Oh, it's just been a great ride. We've loved every minute of this, and this is the ultimate.
Yeah, you never dream when they start out. It is a dream, of course, but you never think it will actually happen. Now it's happening, and you just reflect back on all the last 30 years since he started hockey.
You know, he's got the reputation around hockey as being a great teammate, a guy who breaks up a lot. You know, Mike Modano campaigned for him to stay in Dallas, but he already signed in St. Louis. Was he always like this? Was he always this kind of fun guy?
Oh, he was a hard one. He was
always
tough one to raise. Just a final thing for you, Aaron. Just there's something you wrote on the ice. What was that?
Well, I can't give that secret away. It's a little secret. I learned that from my good buddy Ricky Bobby. There it is right there. Those are little secrets that I'm going to carry with me for a long time, but I just want to say one special thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
I want to say hello to my grandma back home, Grandma Payne, and all my aunts and uncles, and everybody that's helped me, all my great friends back home, and thank you very much for all you guys' support. I love yous all, and I never would be here without yous, everybody.
Congratulations, Aaron. Congratulations to your parents.
Yeah!
Scott?
Elliot, thanks very much. Ron did speak to Darren McCarty earlier, but this is a treasured moment. This is Griffin and Emerson, Darren's kids. You know, Darren's journeys go. You have been on a heck of a one this year, from substance abuse to the Stanley Cup. Is there a luckier man in the world tonight?
You know, I don't think so. I think just, the miracles have happened to me daily. Obviously, with these guys are a big part of it. I think that's why it means so much, is to be able to share it with. We got half of them. The younger two stayed at home. We missed them, but we'll be able to celebrate with them soon.
Okay, Griffin, you remember back in 02 when your dad won the Stanley Cup and you were six, right?
Yeah.
So is he going to put you on his shoulders tonight like he did back then?
If he wants to host about 120 pounds, then I guess he can.
First thing I told him was, dude, I don't know. You might be a little too big to hold up. I think it might be Emmy's turn.
What do you think, Emerson? You enjoying the celebration? How much?
Lots.
Yeah, I bet.
You know, Darren, when the Wings signed you back in February, you really only wanted to get your life back in order. Did you ever think that your recovery could include such a special moment?
I think as the journey went along and just things were developing and obviously getting an opportunity in Grand Rapids and playing and having success there and coming up here and with some injuries early in the playoffs, it allowed me to play more. And I watched this team even when I was gone and I knew how great they were, and it was just nice to be able to come in and add something.
Congratulations, Darren.
Scott, I appreciate
you deserve it.
Thank you.
All right. Kirk Maltby. Here's the Maltby crew.
There we are.
Introduce us.
This is my 4-year-old Ella. Say hi, Elle.
Hi.
This is my wife Wendy and her best
hi.
Friend Melissa.
Hi.
So how y'all doing?
Great.
What's going on here tonight?
A lot better now.
Kirk, you're one of five of the Wings to win your fourth Stanley Cup. Let me ask you this. How does it feel to play for an organization that measures success, not just in terms of making the playoffs, but in winning it all?
Yeah, you know, I gave Mr. and Mrs. Illich a big hug afterwards too, and thanked them, because without the ownership that we have, I mean, I don't think this all this stuff would have happened through, at least since I've been here. And it's and it's been awesome. It's been an awesome ride, and this is a great way to end this year. And you know, being as close as we were last game, you know.
You're beautiful, by the way.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you say hi to everyone back in Cambridge?
What's it say, Kirk, about an organization where you have five players? Because there's so much player movement these days, especially in the cap world. As we see Mario Lemieux, who's congratulating Mike Ilitch right now, but let me get back to the question. What's it say about an organization where you have five players stick around for 11 years to share in this success?
Well, I think it's been a little bit of give and take on both sides. You know, the management is definitely, you know, definitely the management has done what they, you know, a lot of loyalty and keeping guys here and bringing guys back and whatnot, and then at the same time the players just love playing here. Detroit's such a great city and a great sports town that there's nowhere I'd rather be.
Who are you thinking of tonight, Kirk?
She wants to go say hi to everyone, but you know, I wasn't married or didn't have any kids the last time we won this, so this is gonna be a special time. We're expecting twins in July, so it's gonna be, you know, very hectic but crazy summer.
Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. Thanks,
Elliot.
Well, if you want to win this, you should sign Mark Hartigan, who's a free agent in the offseason, because last year he won it in Anaheim, and this year he wins it in Detroit. How does this celebration compare?
They're all awesome. You doesn't get old. Doesn't get old. Give a shout out to Fort St. John and my boy Ducky. Woo! Love you, buddy! Yeah!
Compare the two organizations, Anaheim, the players love playing there, Detroit, the players love playing here. How do they compare, Mark?
Do you know what? They were different, you know, but they're both great teams. It's hard to compare the two. You know, they're both champions. And it's just a matter of consistency and hard work out there and playing the game to what the coaches want you to play.
Your old university roommate Ryan Malone was crying as he came off the ice tonight. That's got to be as hard as it gets, but you want to bet with him. What does he have to do for you this summer?
He's got to babysit my daughter for a weekend.
You really want to leave your babysitter under the care, daughter under the care of Ryan Malone?
That is true. I just got to make sure his wife's around too.
All right, thanks very much, Mark. Congratulations.
No, thank you very much.
Scott?
All right, Elliot, what a stunning impression Darren Held made in these Stanley Cup playoffs, and the final in particular with your world-class speed, as Mike Babcock has repeatedly described it. Have you figured out yet where you are? Because a year ago, you were playing junior in Medicine Hat.
Yeah, it's I couldn't have dreamt this up last year junior and didn't expect to be here this year. So, you know, all things said, and extremely excited, extremely happy to be part of this team and be part of, Stanley Cup.
No, your family's not here tonight, but a good buddy of yours from Selkirk is Jason Vitt. You played junior with him, junior B, right? And I know when a guy makes it to the NHL, most of the guys he played junior with or midget with always say, I was better than that guy at a certain age. So was that the case here?
No, not in this case. I have to give all the credit to him. I like to tell people back home that I did teach him, but no, he was a little bit better.
Great for you, Jason, to be here tonight to share in the celebration. Darren, Mike Babcock said you've been called up twice this year. The first time you were called up, he said that you were afraid to play, and he was afraid to play you. Is that fair?
Yeah, I think so. First time being NHL, I was pretty nervous. Next time I was feeling pretty good and was able to step in the lineup and, you know, just give it all I had and, you know, play with a lot of energy and just, you know, just go and do what I could.
You know, the Red Wings like to keep their younger players in the minors for at least two, maybe 3 years. You may break that mold, do you think?
I sure hope so. It's obviously I knew that usually they like to keep guys in the juniors or in the minors a little bit longer, but hopefully I made a pretty good impression here, and next year I can get a better shot in making the team.
All right, you'll be taking the Stanley Cup back to St. Andrews for at least one day. Who are you thinking of tonight, Darren?
My parents for sure. They've helped me out so much along the way, and I got so many friends and family back at home too, and everybody, there's been so many people that helped me and supported me along the way, and it's unbelievable, and I couldn't have asked for a better fan support than the ones I got back home.
Congratulations, Darren.
Thanks a lot.
Darren Helm, two huge goals in the Stanley Cup final. Elliot?
Well, from one Winnipegger to another, we've got Derek Meach and his father, Darren. And Dennis, my apologies. Good start for me on this one. But, last year, Winnipeg celebrated Teemu Selänne's win. This year, two of their own native sons. And just a word about your dad and what it means to have him here with you tonight.
Oh, it's unbelievable. I mean, obviously, I'd always want to contribute in the way of being on the ice. But having my family here and on all my... my stepmom's also here. It's unbelievable. I can't even explain the feeling right now. It's kind of it's gonna be a blur, but It's so important for me to have him here. We've been through some tough times in our lives, but now this is definitely paying off.
You know, Dennis, every father says, or every mother says, all they want to see in life is their children succeed and be happy. To see your son succeed and be as happy as he is right now, what comes to your mind?
Just a huge accomplishment. And he's worked incredibly hard through his entire career, all the way through childhood and everything else. And the role he played this year was tough, but he gave it all he had every day throughout the season. And I'm proud of him beyond belief. So,
is there a story that stands out about him that you would like all the viewers in Canada to know about your son?
Gosh, he's just a terrific guy, and one of the wonderful things that I hear from people that he comes into association with outside of the hockey rink is that they're really pleased with his attitude and the type of person that he is.
How are you going to celebrate this one?
Oh, I think we're going to have a pretty good time tonight, and for about a week and a half, 2 weeks straight, I think. Here we go. It's going to be awesome.
Congratulations, Derek Meach, for a huge accomplishment.
Congratulations to the entire Meach family. Enjoy it tonight,
Thank
guys.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it greatly.
Ron?
Great Red Deer Rebel right there.
Let's. Scott Bowman was already out of fingers for Stanley Cup rings. He's got his 11th tonight. Scotty, let me ask you, what defines this team that separates it perhaps from the previous three Stanley Cup wins in the last 11 years?
Well, as you know, the new NHL, this team had to cut payroll quite a bit. And I think it was the way that Kenny Holland, his staff, the way they worked to, get players that they could afford and also develop the ones they had. And Coach Babcock, I think Mike did a tremendous job. When you look at Datsuk Zetterberg and you saw Val Filippula, he's brought him along. But I would think that the difference in this team from most teams that I saw this year was the defense corps. I really don't think that any of us, Scott, knew how good Brian Rafalski was. I mean, he was a standout with the Devils, and to get him and put him with Nick Lidstrom after the loss of Matthew Schneider, and also to bring along young Cronwell and make the deal for Brad Stewart. So, but I think the way the defense corps, they not only could defend, but they were, if you look through the records, they scored big goals. They had three 40-point men, or maybe 50 points, I don't know. But they had offense, they had defense.
Scott, we're running out of time. I want to get one quick comment from you. Keep it as brief as you can, because we've got to get back to Ron. But what's the one thing you tried to pass on to Mike Babcock, who relied on you quite heavily?
Well, accountability. And that's the kind of coach he is, you know, and his staff was terrific. So I would say he makes the players accountable. And, you know, he likes players that play two ways.
Scott, thanks for your time. Congratulations.
Thank you.